Hello, my name is Wenping. Previously, I went through OverTheWire Bandit Wargames level 0 to 6. Those early stages test on the fundamentals of one's knowledge in Linux understanding and ways to solve basic challenges. Today, I'll be going through level 7 to 12, which will be tougher and more fun to solve. For level 7, the password is stored in the data.txt file next to the word millionth. Grep is a super useful tool which allows you to print lines that matches a pattern. It is commonly used in the real world by both attackers and defenders to find keywords and look for specific information. In this case, we will cat the data.txt file and then we will pipe the output to grep for the word millionth to find the password. There you go, this is the password to go to level 8. For beginners who are unfamiliar with pipe, it basically allows your next command to process the output of your first command. In this case, when you cat the file, its content will be the input that are provided to the grep command. For level 8, the password is once again stored in the data.txt file and it is the only line of text that occurs only once. If we cat the data.txt file, we can see that the content is pretty long. It doesn't make sense to manually find a single line of text that only appears once. What if we pipe the output to unit-c? What it does is basically performing a comparison between each line of text with its previous line to check if they are unique. As you can see, all the lines only has one occurrence because they are not sorted. Therefore, the comparison shows that they all only appear once. If you sort the content in data.txt first, it will work like a charm. There you go, this is the password to go to level 9, as it is the only line that has only one occurrence. The rest of the lines has 10 occurrences each. Unique-c is very useful if you want to find out the exact number of occurrences for any lines. For example, if the challenge wants you to find something that appears for like 5 times or 6 times, you can use this method. For this specific instance, whereby you just need to know which line appears only once, a faster way is to use unique-u. This will only show you the line that appears only once. For level 9, the password is stored in data.txt in one of the human readable strings preceded by several equal signs. If you cat the data.txt file, you will see a lot of gibberish output like this. This is because this is not a human readable file. To read its few human readable strings, you can make use of the strings command. Since the level goal mentioned that the password is preceded by several equal signs, we shall grep for 2 equal signs. There you go, this is the password to go to level 10. For level 10, the password is once again stored in data.txt, but they are base64 encoded. Base64 is a very commonly used encoding in real life, used by many applications. The beauty of encoding is that you can always decode the content that were previously encoded. If you cat the file, you can see the base64 encoded string. Fun fact, if you have worked on base64 encoding content for long enough, you can actually recognize it in one look. In this challenge, we are going to make use of the base64 tool. Base64-D allows you to decode and print the content of a file. There you go. This is the password to go to level 11. For level 11, the password is stored in data.txt, whereby every alphabet were rotated by 13 positions. If you refer to the helpful reading materials mentioned below, there is this ROT13 on Wikipedia. ROT13 is a substitution cipher. To solve this challenge, we need to use a ROT13 decoder. Based on my knowledge, there is no such tool available on Linux by default. However, there are many websites that does it, such as ROT13.com. There you go, this is the password to go to level 12. For level 12, the password is stored in data.txt, which is a hex dump of a file that has been repeatedly compressed. This is the biggest hint, repeatedly compressed. The next part is something very important, as this instruction will be applied in multiple challenges moving forward as well. As everyone playing the Bandit Wargame will be logged in to the same host, they cannot possibly allow everyone to be creating files everywhere. Therefore, the permission is set up in a way that an authenticated user can only create a subdirectory in /temp/something. In this case, since you need to create file and stuff in order to complete this level, you need to apply this instruction. Since the level goal mentioned that this is a hex dump, we need to reverse it back to its original state of a compressed file. We can achieve that by using the SSD tool. This is a tool for creating a hex dump or to reverse it. SSD-R is the command to revert a hex dump by converting it back into a binary file. Next, we can make use of the file command to find out what is the file type of this binary file. As you can see, this is a gzip compressed file. In order to decompress the file correctly to view its content, we need to rename it to .gz extension and decompress it using gunzip. Once again, we use the file command to check the file type, and this time, it is a bzip2 file. So from this point onwards, we will just keep repeating the same process of checking the file type, and then rename the file, decompress it, and view its content. Finally, we have an ASCII text file. There you go. This is the password to go to level 13. With this, I have come to the end of my step-by-step walkthrough of Over the Wire Bandit Wargame series for level 7 to 12. I hope this detailed walkthrough has been useful to you in your learning and help you understand the new concepts that were being introduced through the challenges. Learning cybersecurity can be fun. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Stay tuned for more videos in the series.